And here's a, I think this was a, that's Phragmites, I think. And this, he did it with a foreshaft. This one. The other end, the end might be in here, broke at some point.
Yeah, otherwise it exploded.
Here it is. That's the, there's the other end of it. That was dyed turkey feathers. This is very lightweight. I don't actually like it because, I mean, if it's really perfectly straight, it'll fly well. But you have no weight, really, to the thing. So it's strictly for short distances. That's kind of a fancy cut. You don't really need to do anything like that. I'll recommend you just keep it simple like this. And I have colorful feathers that I got at Michael's because it's hard to get feathers cheap, good ones. So your feathers will look, they'll be very gay arrows. Okay. I mean that in the number one definition.
Yeah, number one Webster's definition.
Yeah,
gay law.
Something like that. And then this
party
is,
time.
I have a bag of these guys, just arrowheads out of stone. This was Nakshon Rose. I don't know if any of you guys know, but he made this at Sinew. What was the deal with the foreshaft? You could save this and redo it over and over, and this thing might shatter, right?
Yeah, if you were to tie it to the Phragmites, it's structurally really weak.
Uh-huh.
So I'm in fact the whole
thing. Well, see, actually, this shoved in here. He had it just glued and tied. See, I didn't even realize that. It cracked and went in. So this is what you end up reusing over and over.
Right.
Put a hard thing on here. Right? No, the other way around?
What I was read and also told that the hard part of the arrow to make is this, the feathers, the missile shaft. So when it went into an animal, you pull it out and sometimes and save this and the actual tip, which you're going to lose anyhow. The arrow head, even if you don't hit the animal, hits a rock and it's gone. I mean, so they're really expendable. But if you can save these, that's why the foreshaft was developed with the atlatl and the arrows. Plus, it makes a nice straight arrow.
Yeah, so everybody look for shortcuts, right? So if this broke off, you have this. The straightness of the shaft is the key factor in making a good arrow. You know, it doesn't matter how fancy it is. You want a straight shaft. The feathers are not. There's a slight twist to them. You see how there's a slight. Some people do them straight down, but usually people make them with a slight twist so that they spin like the rifling inside of a rifle chamber. So the bullet is actually twirling as it's going through the air. This can take a lot of work. We're not going to do any flint napping today. I think you were.
I was trying to get rid of stuff.
I thought Paul was coming.
What? You're not going. Paul's up in Fraser Park. He's snowed in.
But, oh.
Because of the grapevine.
Is the five closed?
I don't think it's
closed. Second email.
It was my fault, though. It was my fault. I shouldn't have even bothered me last night.
Why is she speaking in terms of Paul?
I don't
know.
It's got that reddish color to it. That would be nice, too.
Well, that would be for the wrapper or whatever. So this is just some miscellaneous stuff.
No, just go.
But even like this, oh, this was a simple atlatl.
Is that the one we? No.
I don't remember, but this was like to make a simple atlatl. You don't have to make it complicated. This is Bob Pearson atlatl. So you guys could cut, you could cut long mulefats too. You might find some long willow shafts today. And that's another one that I made. That's a little more involved. See, his has a little button here. I didn't bring my lateral shafts, but it's an Easton aluminum arrow that's hollow, so it just fits right into here, to the socket. That's a little timing device. This one is more traditional, easier, universally, just make a hole. Put whatever arrow you have there and hurl it. But I find this still a little bit big. This is actually remarkably easy to use. Just don't throw it.
I won't.
Watch Billy.
Oh, Bill, get him. You're sweet. But that's the way it works.
Huh?
I don't want to throw hard because it's so long.
This is another atlatl.
You want to go for another walk that way.
See that? See how that fits the hand real nice?
They had to climb the tree to get something. Oh, yeah.
See,
that's
this.
Right.
Where's the other one? This
one. Yeah, that's a nice.
This one actually has a. This is really no good. Look at that. I mean, I don't know why even. You can't have that kind of a curve. I was just showing how to find a natural curve, natural little angle. Like you do that for a pipe. It'd be okay for a pipe, but not for an atlatl. That's going to totally distort it.
Right?
If that was perfectly straight, it'd be okay.
Well, if you. You can make it bent.
It could be bent. You could bend it if you had
to. It's still a little low.
Yeah, this could be bent.
Try
this
one.
You could heat this.
Yeah,
usually you like that hard.
I like to.
It's just that the arrow didn't have weight to it. Otherwise, it would have gone.
I like to go across the arrow, but there's no way we can do it today. There's so much water in the arrow. Huh?
Ash has volunteered to swim across the lake. We'll watch.
That's fine. I don't mind watching her swim.
I don't mind.
That's okay.
I'm not going to go into the muddy muck.
It's had little practice.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Had little practice.
There she goes.
I like that.
We do?
Oh, this one.
You like that one better?
Oh, yeah, because it's got the arch on it.
It's kind of on the fat side. See how I did the wrapping? No knots.
Yeah, but it's got that weight that'll give it more thrust.
The weight? Okay. This is much lighter. This, they always wondered why they found those with atlatls. Oh, there's Gary. This actually gives it more forward propulsion. They would tie rocks onto them. Sometimes you see little things that they thought were amulets in caves.
Yeah.
And they thought it was, they would call them charms, archaeologists would call them charms, and religious curio or something like that always means we haven't got a clue what that thing is. religious curio.
There's another reason why they put those on there.
Huh?
Is
religious curio?
Let's see. No, well, that could be, but the reason that I'm speaking of is often these darts are really long, like over 6 feet long. And when you're hunting and a deer, he's got his head up, that means he's alert, he's looking around. You're waiting there for the deer to put his head down so you can take your shot, so he's not going to run off as soon as you do this. So you're here with a long, long spear, and you're ready to throw. This thing is getting heavy. So the purpose of this is it helps to balance the weight so that all of the weight isn't out here. It's holding it.
But it's good.
Because you hold for 5 minutes like this in a throwing position, you got this thing way out there. You know, your muscles are, they've done a lot of tests on those, and they actually test the muscles.
You guys ever see Deliverance? Remember the guy hunting? He didn't have a compound. You know, when you have a compound bowl with the wheels, you're pulling back 60 pounds and then you're holding like a 20.
Right.
But he had a regular recurve, and he was trying to shoot the hillbilly. Right? He's going like this. It's a lot of weight, like the same principle, what Jim's talking about.
They did two tests, one with the weight, and there was like no muscle tension here. They did one without the weight. It was just incredible, the muscle tension.
Yeah, leverage.
Yeah, exactly. So that's a big thing to remember if you ever get into that and you want to find two of them.
Well, what is it?
In the 70s, we're saying a quick ice age.
Snowing in Pasadena.
Ice age. So let's get under a tree.
Like quintessential of, you know, having a stereo being held over your hand.
Yeah. We got our mule fat, now we're gonna make some arrows.
Well,
what are you doing?
I'm cutting the notch in the back. There you go.
Oh, very cool. How'd you do that?
You cut the notch in, you have to cut it in the right shape so you can get the arrow point in, and then you wet the sinew and tied around it, and it will tighten up.
So it tightens when it dries.
Yes.
Brilliant.
Three good ones. You're going to use three because, number one,
first of all, you want to get all of them from the same wing.
Same curve.
Okay, otherwise they won't push on the left. Okay.
So from the same side.
No, but
the same wing. A right wing and a left wing are going to twist different. These are all right
wings. These are all the same.
Right.
Okay.
The curve will be one way or the other.
This is a left wing.
You wouldn't want to use both sides.
No.
That's correct. You're going to use one side or the other.
So that's the same wing, so you want to be...
This is a left wing. You see the difference?
Can you see that? The concavity is like here, Spets.
So
you don't want to mix and match those.
Otherwise, they will not lay straight.
So if you're going to use this part on this one, you wouldn't use this other part. You want to use...
Right, we're going to use the big part. You're going to use the big part. For example, you're going to do one like this. The perpendicular one, let's do the off color, just so you recognize when you pull out your arrow. So you're going to use this piece. Let's get you a better one. You do your talk. You do the tutorial. Just so you first off, you want to, the selection is important.
Yeah. Then you want to look for the same width here.
Okay.
So they'll be about right. You're going to want three matching widths.
And that's a good.
When you cut it, and he's right. But when you cut it, you want to have a half inch or quarter inch on each end longer. Because that's where you're
going to. Of the rib he's talking about.
Of the rib, where you cut it. Okay, so if you want to, your fletching to be actually that much feather, then let's.
That's a nice blade he's using, by the way.
Also, the Amazonian Indians typically use two feathers.
Yeah, there's some that have four. There are many variations of this.
Okay, then cut it here.
Okay.
And it'll just pull apart. Then they'll split right here.
Because he only wants the one half. So this real carefully. I've got scissors, you guys, also. I wouldn't advise you until you're really good at it to use what the tool Rick has, because that's, if Bob was using that, we would have been probably picking the tip of his finger off the ground.
No, I'm not pulling, cutting to myself, see?
I'm not going
to
talk about Bob. Bob was doing that, just so. You're doing it good.
In the woods, you can, if you get a nice sharp edge on your stone, you do the same thing.
Okay, now that'll be one of your feathers.
Yeah.
Okay, this is the, when I told you about making it longer, it's because what you want to do is cut this.
See, that little stem that Rick is creating, that's so you can actually attach the feather to your shaft. So you guys are going to make three of these doing exactly what Rick just is showing you here. And you can take your scissors and trim the arrow, the feather, I mean, but you don't really need to. And explain about the inside. You may want to scrape this to make it flat.
Yeah, to make it a little bit flat.
Although it doesn't make a whole lot of difference.
So on some, it does.
Now, this is going to be what they call the cock feather.
Okay.
And so you're going to have to pick out which side's going to, you know, as your arrowhead is vertical.
Yeah.
You want this to be horizontal, 90 degrees.
Perpendicular to the plane of the arrow.
And then you put it
of
there.
Of the head.
Okay? And then you have these little things to tell you. I would take and put some cinnamon now in a bucket of water for you.
Okay, not everybody agrees.
and get ready to start wrapping. Because
certainly perpendicular to the knock.
Yeah. Well, that's why when she put the arrow point on, and then cut the knock. She was advised that the knock and the arrowhead should be in alignment.
Right. Now, I'm just saying, I would agree if Longbow said that. It doesn't have to be that way, but you do want it. You do want to at least focus on the cock feather or one of them perpendicular to the knock, because that's really important when you shoot it. Yeah. Oh no, that's real important.
So each one of these now.
Because your arrow will be this way when you shoot
it.
You want that one feather perpendicular and the other two off to the angle so that it slides by your string without getting hung up.
Yeah, that's
so you
true.
Do need one feather perpendicular to the knock.
Okay.
Yep.
So you guys are going to cut the three feathers like Rick showed?
It also helps you target when you pull out a...
Exactly. You know exactly where to align it, of course. So you guys are going to do this, and then we, once you get all three cut, you have your sinew wet, and we do the wrap. That takes art.
Does anybody use that mold?
This one?
Yeah, I'll put some more in.
Yeah, let's do that, because then people have to stick the crap in their mouth.
Well, you told me I had this.
She's using it as a template.
I would give a little bit more speed.
Yeah, I probably would feather off, so you have more to tie on to your shaft.
It's easy to pull more off.
Again, that's a very sharp instrument, so just be very careful.
Another way they do it is they take this and they place it.
place it right on here like that, and just press down, and then pull the feather this way.
So, you know, probably if all of the aspects of arrow making, dealing with the feather is what you're going to find the most variations and possibilities and personal opinions and, you know, this way, that way. The bottom line, everything Rick said is correct, though. You want all the feathers to be from the same side, the same curve, and then how you attach them. There's many, many ways people do it. So by just trying it, you're going to see that it's a little trickier than you might think. But again, overall with the arrow, once the points are made, and your points could also be metal that you've flattened out, right? Because a lot of the Indians stop flint knapping when they can get metal. They have little triangles of metal, use those for their points, and they're reusable a lot better. So your shaft is the key, straight shaft, right? You secure your tip, you have a nock, the arrows help make it fly straight. And some of them didn't even have arrows. And actually, you could use bark, or like modern plastic ones, you could use other material besides the feathers.
Is that the thinner one over here?
It dries. These micro feathers are, I think they're goose that they die.
They're gooses.
Yeah, they died already. There.
Yeah, they definitely died.
But they're, but you've seen those at Michael's, right?
Worked there for 7 years of my life. Am I getting in the right place right there?
Adios, baby.
As long as it's not in the way of that, right?
I'm going to take off, everybody.
Bye.
Thank you very much.
You.
Wonderful day.
All
right. Take care.
I'll see you.
Have fun.
Yeah.
You take care of yourself. Nice meeting you.
Take care of yourself.
You're welcome.
That was an interesting class.
Take it easy, Rick.
It didn't quite work out exactly because of the rain. I thought the snow was the highlight as far as I'm concerned.
That was a great day.
Yeah. It was almost magical, you know, when it was snowing.
Good.
Okay.
I think next week we'll be here again.
I don't remember actually.
I'm showing you that there's a tracking. Everything you do is
muscle.
Really?
I'll remember to become strong.
It would be now.
It would be, yeah. In fact, so
I may go to that.
Yeah, okay.
I'll find out during the week.
Okay, I won't hold it against you.
I'll find out.
It should be a good class, but they're doing good.
Where did the rest of the team go?
What are you doing?
Yeah.
I don't remember. Do you remember what's on my schedule for next
week? And it just cover up. It'll just go right over there. And when it dries, it'll stick together just like plastic. That's a very good job.
Yay! Well, you guys will help me.
Very good.
I don't know. I didn't help you.
It's in life.
Dance and burnishing a rosewood arrow with a piece of antler.
But any wood, not just rosewood.
Okay. Makes the fibers very strong.
Yeah, because you're compressing them together.
So I compressed
wood.
You want that to be like that. You
like a drumstick.
You want to stretch it on and it will stick to itself. This is not, there's no such thing as bad stitching.
I just loop it like that.
Okay.
Uh-huh. And I hold it like this. And I put my point in there.
Uh-huh.
Okay. And then I take this and I hold it like this. And then I start wrapping. Wrap it real tight. Now remember, my point is in there. I'm wrapping it real tight like that. Okay.
Uh-huh.
And you keep wrapping. Then I take this end,
okay,
and I put it through the loop. Take this end here, put it through the loop, like this, okay. Then I take this end here, okay, and I pull it.
Oh, cool.
Pull it into, and sometimes you gotta use, I usually make that a little bit longer, but. You pull that.
I get the idea.
Yeah. It's so tight that what you can do is just pull this part here and into it like that.
Huh.
Uh-huh. And you cut off this end, and this thing is solid on there.
Cool.
It just, it won't move, you know. Now I let this end loose. I normally would have wrapped this too, but.
Yeah. But, it's all good. Get the idea.
But once you loop it, put it in there, and pull it through the wraps, it's solid. It's not going to move. And you cut that end off.
That's cool.
It really stays tight.